The next stage of our process is that we will go through the commissioning process. Once your system is connected and powered on, it'll emit a wireless hotspot that you can connect to. Open any mobile device or laptop and look for a Wi-Fi network that says Verdigris dash and the serial number of your system. In this case, we've installed system 10001308. I'm going to connect to that system. And see, I'm connected. Sometimes your mobile device will switch over to your mobile network instead of the hotspot. And just to avoid that, we're going to turn off our mobile data right now. You can also do this by going into airplane mode. So once you're connected to the hotspot, open any web browser and go to your favorite URL. In this case, mine is verdigris.co. The hotspot will navigate you to the commissioning page of our system. In the configuration page, you'll see a splash screen that asks you to select the region. I'm in the United States, so I'll select that, and I'm going to begin configuration. The first thing we do is we enter the panel name. In this case, I'm running through this demo for you, so I'm going to call my panel demo. The next stage is to assign the cable colors of your panel. In this case, I am black, red, blue, so I'm going to leave those colors as is. For special options such as voltage override and powered by single phase, please refer to your system manual, as those specialty configurations are covered in that manual. The next step is to assign my voltage taps. So at the top of my bud, there were connections A, B, and C. And I connected them in a very specific order. And I connected tap A to a black wire, tap B to a red wire, and tap C to a blue wire. And those were the three phases of my panel. So I'll tell the system that that's how they're connected right now. And now my system has auto-detected the types of current transformers that are connected. In this case, on my chain 2, I have 6 Verdigris CTs. I'm going to identify the first CT and enter its name. In this case, it's an office receptacle, and I will call it office receptacle 1. I will choose a cable color that it's attached to. In this case, it was attached to a black phase, and I'm going to hit next. Now for the second CT, it's on the same three-phase breaker as my first one. So I'm going to say it's on the same breaker. You'll see office receptacle 1 is automatically copied in. And I'll select the cable color, basically the phase of that circuit, which is red. And hit next. For my third CT, also same, but this time blue. Now I'm on another bank of CTs. So in this case, this will be my chiller pump. So I'm going to call this pump 1. And it's also connected to a black phase. Likewise, this is the same phase. It's pump 2. And finally, same phase connected to blue. And I'm going to complete my connections. In this final summary, you'll see a summary of the connections that you made so that you can review them once to make sure that they're connected the way you expect them to be. When you're on the screen to configure the CT, to identify which CT you're on, the CT that you're currently commissioning will begin to flash and all the other ones will remain dark. So now I know that this CT on this chain is this first one coming out of the bud, which is right here. As I progress towards the second CT in the chain, the second CT will light up. So there's an indication to say what you're actually labeling and commissioning is what physical CT that corresponds to. Next in the commissioning process, we'll want to upload a photo of the panel just to remind ourselves how the installation was. That way, if we make any mistakes during commissioning, we can go back and refer to the photo and see what we might have done. So in this case, I'm going to open my camera app. I'm going to take a picture of my installation. I hit OK. And it has a photo to upload, and I'm going to save it with my commissioning data. Lastly, you'll want to connect your data to your, you want to connect your data connectivity to your base transmitter unit. In this case, our unit is equipped with both Wi-Fi and 4G. But for the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to walk you through the Wi-Fi connection. If you have an LTE connection, all you really need to do is hit LTE and it'll connect. In Wi-Fi configuration, you'll see a list of potential access points to which you can connect. In this case, I know my local data network is Verdigris Wi-Fi, so I'll enter that. I will put in the password to that, and this is our office Wi-Fi, so I'm going to type it in a little bit more discreetly. Once you have the password saved in, you submit that, and the system will utilize the credentials that you provided it to attempt to connect to that same Wi-Fi network. Once that's done, it will come back with a confirmation. It could take a few minutes to connect, but once it does, it'll come back and say, this Wi-Fi network is okay.